Your boy has seen the light, and it was beautiful. I wasn't going to make a video about Ready or Not until next week, but this was so sudden that I just had to. If anyone remembers, not too long ago, I had reported on a Twitch streamer named Clean. He had claimed that he had seen an exclusive trailer for Ready or Not. At the time, I had a hunch that what he had seen wasn't the full-on gameplay trailer, but something smaller. And today, I was proven right. But how do I know this? Well, at about 1 in the morning when I was sleeping and dead tired, I could hear the Discord app ringing. So I hobbled my way over to my desk and I noticed that it was one of the developers contacting me. I was actually surprised to see who it was. Okay. He wanted to show me what they showed to Leviathan, the people who were helping Void get other licenses for the guns in-game. Ladies and gentlemen, this game is real. And what I'm about to tell you is exactly what I saw. The clip started up with a guy moving slowly down a hallway. Everything looked blue, like a dark navy blue, kind of like the pictures we've already seen on their Twitter. And he was holding a pistol. I was unsure as to what pistol he was holding. I think it was a Glock, but I could be wrong. I'm not sure about that one. Then it cuts over to a guy holding what looked like a SCAR with a holo sight on. He was shooting at somebody and I couldn't really tell who it was, but there was two or three SWAT officers that were both on each side charging this one guy. These SWAT officers also had names on them. When you look at them, the names pop up. And I also think it showed like a health bar too, but I don't remember it clearly. I just remember the names. I believe I saw Ryro and Zed. That's how you say that. I'm not sure. And Easy Street, I think it was. I really couldn't tell what this area was because the lens flare was a bit too flashy for me. But then it cuts over to the next scene, which is of the same guy, I believe, but with night vision goggles on. It seemed like the night vision goggles obscured the vision just a little bit, but not too much. It does like a kind of a circle around the screen, but it doesn't cover up everything. Not enough to really obscure your vision, but just enough to simulate that you have night vision goggles on. And his holosight is aiming at crates, shipping crates. A very familiar sight to any viewers that's actually watched some of my videos. We know that we've seen these from the pictures and videos that Void has put out. So he's like aiming at it for a bit, and then he kind of like turns away, and then the clip cuts to another scene. Then it switches to a guy who has a wall to his left and a wall in front of him. What was interesting about this guy is that he is reloading, and there was a little tiny icon that showed up on his palm saying how much was left in the mag. It wasn't a number or anything like that. It was just a mag icon showing how full or empty it was. It was very tiny and easy to miss. Like, I didn't even realize until the dev actually pointed it out. Then it cuts to another scene where it shows off a SWAT officer that's walking into what looks like a big train station. It was very bright and looked a lot like the picture that's on the screen right now for you guys to see. The officers were like walking in from like a hallway into like that big area. They were walking in from like a hallway off to the side into that big area. And then after that, it cuts to another part where I believe this place was the training area that we've seen in previous pictures. It shows the character holding an Opti-Wan. Man, that Opti-Wan looks really cool. It looks so modern. But basically, he's standing up, putting out the Opti-Wan to look around the corner. I don't recall if you saw anything because he's actually turning off the screen and he's about to put it away, but then the clip cuts to the next scene. I also noticed that Grunter had his name on the bottom screen of the Opti-Wan. So can you name your Opti-Wans? That's pretty cool. The developer was talking to me when this part was going on. He was saying that this Opti-Wan has more than one purpose. You can adjust how good the resolution is apparently and switch to other people's cameras too. This is great because back in SWAT 4, we would have to individually Opti-Wan the door. Now, in Ready or Not, only one person needs to do it and we can all see his one Opti-Wan. That's really cool. Then the scene cuts from there and switches to the training area again, but there's a guy standing in front of the camera guy. I believe it's a civilian, but I'm not too sure about that. And then the camera guy proceeds to arrest the perp. I don't recall if he pulled out the zip tie before arresting. I think he had his primary out, and then when he did the animation to cuff, which looked really nice by the way, he pulled out a zip tie. Like, he did a whole animation where he goes in and he grabs his hand and he cuffs him. It looks so nice. It also didn't look like the suspect was on his knees because he was standing up. That's literally all that I can remember. God damn it. I wish I could show you guys, but unfortunately I was not able to download the clip. I was only able to replay it twice. So everything that I just told you is based off of muscle memory. Believe you me, if I was able to download this clip, I would have done a full-on analysis. This video would have been a hell of a lot longer because you know how I get in depth with these, you know, these videos. It was only a 30-second gameplay clip, but there was so much that was going on it, so much that I can't really remember. remember. It didn't have any audio, but I was able to see all the cool looking animations, and man, those animations and mechanics put together just look so nice. Oh, I wish I could show you guys. But that day will come soon. Soon. Well, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.